This is a Chrome extension that makes YouTube ads unavoidable. For example, if you happen to get an advertisement while watching a YouTube video and you're not looking directly at that corner of the screen where the ad is playing, that ad will automatically pause. And if you look back at the screen, that ad will unpause. And this is only the beginning of what this magnificent extension will be capable of.
My ad blocker?
Industries!
Please, let me alone. Leave me alone, please.
What is this?
Okay,
each
nice.
Topic has suggestions to take your spin.
Boston Industries! We are not in Boston! I hate it!
Anyway, this video is sponsored by Incogni, more on that later. Let's start with eye detection. Your eye creates a simple shape with 6 key points, the corners, top and bottom. To catch anyone trying to cheat by closing their eyes during ads, we need to track 2 measurements, the horizontal line between eye corners and the vertical line from top to bottom. When you blink, that vertical line shrinks while the horizontal stays roughly the same. I tried inspecting the length of the vertical line first and it was usually at 10 and goes to around 4 when I close my eye. Judging by that threshold, we can show blinking on the screen when we detect it. Then we track both eyes, our blinking measurements get more accurate. And if you're blinking for long enough, which probably means you close your eyes, that ad will pause. Imagine there's an ad pausing here, that part isn't actually done yet. Anyway, we take our eye, take that shape we talked about earlier with 6 key points and extract it, apply a threshold so it's black and white, the sclera is white and the iris is black, iris being the circle in your eye, split that fucker in half, count the pixels on each side and display the ratio on screen. Basically the idea here is, you'll have more black pixels in whichever direction you're looking since the iris, being black, will move there, and the opposite part will have the most white pixels. Then we translate all that data to an estimate direction and watch the magic happen. Admittedly, I did have to find the perfect threshold for my use case, and if you'll use the extension you'll have to do the same, but it works. And we detect our face and do our eye calculations every frame because fuck your CPU. Then we turn it into a server, make it communicate with the extension via WebSockets, which you can imagine is 2 walkie-talkies communicating, I think. I've never had. Maybe that's not the best analogy. It's basically 2 scripts sending data to each other on an open port. And we try to get it working with a YouTube video player. After that, I lower the threshold so you have half a second before the program considers that you're looking away.
As a side note, it took me like 10 minutes to get an ad on YouTube.
And I was getting bored.
And kaboom! Our extension can tell if you're looking at a YouTube ad and pauses it if you're not. Speaking of ads and data, you know what's actually fucked? Data brokers. These companies data collect and sell your personal information like it's nothing. IP addresses, browser fingerprints, for real this time, shopping history, location data, if it exists, they're collecting it. These are legitimate businesses whose whole model is just selling your private shit. We're talking about hundreds of these companies building detailed profiles about you, right now. That's why I use today's sponsor, Incogni. They basically force these companies to delete your data by leveraging laws like GDPR and CCPA, which legally make data brokers comply in regions where those laws apply. They have already made 16 companies delete my info, and they keep on finding new ones. And the best part is, once you set it up, it just keeps working. So when those sneaky goblins try to collect your data again, Incogni tells them to automatically fuck off. Want data brokers to stop selling your personal information? Use code FaceDev in the link below for 16% of the annual plan. And there's also a 30-day money-back guarantee option, so you can try it risk-free. Thanks to Incogni for sponsoring this video. And now we're back to Darkeru. That's the project name, by the way. For some reason, I bought too many domains and had no use for this one, so I called the project after it, despite Darkeru.com not having anything on it. Anyway, conclusion is, I buy way too many domains. Next feature. So you know when you're reading an article and there's ads on the sides, in the middle, in the mini player, on the walls? Well, the idea of this feature is to mimic that, but for every website. And my troglodyte brain thought that a big problem would be the fact that every website respects CSS spacing rules, and that we wouldn't be able to just randomly insert advertisements where we find empty space on the page. But then I realized, wait, CSS isn't that shit, we can just make elements on top of the web page. And I did just that.
So we got the most bare bones implementation of the floating window. Something annoying with developing Chrome extensions is that you have to restart it every time you make a change. So my workflow is, if I change something in the script, I have to go here, click restart, restart, and then view it, which is quite annoying. Also, if you wonder why my voice sounds so weird, I'm sick. So I was thinking every ad should have a
title
for the thing they're promoting.
Slogan.
So, for example, a one-liner and
description.
And we should probably make it so if you click on the window content, it redirects you. We could just
cover it in an anchor tag.
Yeah. So if we restart,
click,
and
hell yeah.
But we have some
stuff added from the anchor tag.
So we're gonna do text decorations. None. I think that's the property.
No, it fucking isn't.
Nice. Okay. And it should also do it in another tab. So think it's a... How does that target blank? What do you mean that's what I have to do to make it redirect to another page? What's the logic in that? How do you read this and we go, oh yeah, this means we'll open a new tab. Restart, restart, click, nice. And also, I wanted a cover image. I'm the worst designer you will ever see, by the way. Don't judge anything I make out of this. Yeah, that seems fine. And then to make it prettier, we're gonna do... Holy fuck, is my formatting fucked. Okay, I like it. I like it. Let's make it so every window has a different, like, color theme. See, what I like about developing web stuff is I don't like anything. It fucking sucks. It's the worst experience you can ever have. So, ooh, yeah. Hell yeah. And it should appear okay, nice. Now this is
peak browser experience.
So now we just have to link them to actual ads so it's not a placeholder. But how am I gonna make a ton of ads so it's not like getting repetitive? Okay, so we're at around 1/10 of the way of scraping 5,000 websites to create unique ads for each one. Let me show you the script. We are going through each site and getting the title and description via the metadata tags. And then we feed them to an AI model so it spits out actual usable data from the data we gather. Because sometimes websites such as X, they don't have any description tags. Why are we using X AI? Well, they give everyone $25 worth of free credits. And I'm too lazy to set up a local LLM. And I'm just gonna use Elon Musk's H100. Cause fuck yeah. And it should be done in like a few hours. So until then, let's play Roblox. You know, here's a tip if you wanna parse a huge list. Always make your program have a way of saving and stopping the process. Cause holy fuck, I'm tired of waiting. And if I stop it now, I lose everything. So I went away from my PC to watch some YouTube and I came back to my PC entering a hibernation stage where everything turned off, and now every request is giving connection closed. So if I scroll up, everything is connection closed. I can't fix it. It's running in headless mode. It was at half of the list and I cannot go back to that, so I have to rerun it. Okay, so I added a way for the program to also find the icons of each site. You can see that it kind of works. So I'm gonna leave it running for a few more hours again, and we're gonna see what we end up with.
And we ended up with a fucking gold mine.
Our dataset has around 2,500 unique advertisements. I switched the code from generating random colors to just using the most persistent color in the logo, so every ad feels matching. It was initially running on the extension code, but then I realized it's probably a better idea to just embed it in the dataset, and now it's there. And the funny thing is, I noticed around 2 advertisements for Linux distros, so I decided to burn through my XAI credits once again to provide you with the dataset clean of any Linux-related propaganda, because fuck Elon and fuck Linux. And I can assure you that browsing the web with this extension in its current state is extremely fun and doesn't want to make you pull your hair out.
I can't even tweet in peace.
The next few features were inspired by comments on my recent community post, which you probably missed because you're not subscribed, just saying. Anyway, new feature. So you know when you're trying to download something on the web and there's a septillion download buttons and you have no idea which one to click unless you hyper-focus and read context clues? Oh, download? Shit, which one is it? Okay, this one looks like a scam. This one is completely unrelated. This one is floating. This one tells me I want raw milk. This one is just plain fucking brain rot. This one shares my coordinates with a 7-digit precision and it's just a fucking mess. But you know what? It's not enough of a mess. So now every 8 to 10 seconds you get a new flashy button in a random screen corner that has a bunch of random bullshit like winning random prizes like iPhones, MacBooks, PS5s, random alerts like virus warnings, security alerts, gift cards, weird animations like
pulsating, shaking,
flashing, and whatever the fuck this is. And according to GitHub Copilot, which I got for free thanks to whatever automated process decided my meme repositories were worth of it, don't bring it up to GitHub, I wanna keep my free Copilot. Anyway, it tells me that there's several billion unique possibilities of scam buttons that my code can generate. And we all know that artificial intelligence cannot lie, and it's very good at maths.
Anyways, each button has now a small red X close button in the top right corner that, I'll be honest here, has a 50% chance to actually close the pop-up and a 50% chance to open my YouTube channel in a new tab. I wanted to make it redirect one of those scam looking links to one of my domains, but I'm too lazy for that, so this one will have to suffice. And if you click on the actual banner head, it does the same thing. For the record, this is how I look right in this video script that feature me will probably read out loud for you.
Next feature.
I know most of you dinguses watch my videos from Windows and not Linux, which is a huge win for the underrated Windows community, but most of you also watch my YouTube videos with ad blockers enabled. I know, yeah. Bossing Industries does not support ad blockers. Therefore, the extension can now detect when you have an ad blocker installed and bricks your entire browser until you remove it. Detecting ad blockers was actually harder than I thought it was going to be. My first attempt was clicking fake ad elements in the DOM and checking if they got hidden or removed. This failed because elements can be hidden for many legitimate reasons, which led to false positives, because browser behavior is fuck. I then tried to get smarter by monitoring the network requests. The idea was to watch for those error blocked by client errors that ad blockers typically cause. This approach fell apart because these errors will also show up with normal core violations and content security blocks. And if you don't know what content security block is, let me break it down for you. Anyway, we were catching way too many normal browser security features along with actual ad blocker activity. The third attempt was actually a little more schizophrenic, if you will. I created a bait file named something like prebid-ads.js that ad blockers would automatically block, according to a fucking Stack Overflow answer. No idea if this worked. I think it didn't because it was running in an extension and couldn't reliably serve that bait. And then I finally found a solution. Instead of trying to trick ad blockers or detecting their behavior, I simply try to load the real thing they're designed to block. Big brain. If either the request fails or we get a suspiciously small file, we know an ad blocker is present. And fuck you all, you block origin, unorigin, virgin blocker, pro max, get fucked. Anyway, next feature is serving an unskippable ad somewhere on the screen, except it actually is skippable. You just have to yell Bossing Industries at the top of your lungs to close it.
Bossing Industries.
First I recorded 6 different advertisements, they're all up on my second channel if you want to check them out, and then I made this simple Python script that detects how loud your microphone is. It basically gives the last 3 seconds of audio to Google speech recognition to transcribe when the volume exceeds an arbitrary value.
And for some fucking reason,
Bossing is detected as Boston, the location Boston. So in the code I'm actually checking if you're yelling Boston Industries, which is quite weird, but does the trick I guess. And then I use the same concept I used for the eye contact feature, communicating via WebSockets, and it's working. After 2 to 4 seconds of opening a new website, this type of pop-up ad will appear, and it reappears every 2 to 3 minutes. And now everything that's left to be done is making the UI so we can easily toggle between features we wanna use and features we're not gonna use. Bossing link is online. Fentanyl reactor at maximum level. We activate the fentanyl reactor. We load Bossing Microsoft AI.
If your metro don't trust you, I'm gonna shoot you.
Fentanyl level at 50%. Fentanyl level at 100%.
Connecting to Sri Lankan servers.
Loading into Bossing interface.
Welcome to Bossing Link AI agent face.
TLDR, I used GitHub Copilot to generate the extensions interface and it looks pretty. And that's pretty much everything I had in mind for this. I added instructions for pretty much every folder. The code base is looking clean and fresh. And I sent the extension to a few friends to try. Insert hyperactive montage of funny clips.
I am here again. I have virus. Guitar 6.
Yo, wiggity wiggity.
What up, gang?
There's no way.
Today, we're going to be reviewing this awesome extension made by Dremel, please. Buzzing Industries.
We are gonna test a new shit app what FaceDev just made. So, firstly, we go to YouTube, of course.
My ad blocker? Boy, I can't be the real stigma anymore. I hate this extension already.
Okay, we delete it. I don't need it. Okay, as you say, I don't need you.
Those who know, mango. I'm watching the full video, and you're watching with me together, please. Yes, you're the editor. Yes.
Oh, it works. Yes?
Hey, this is Face. What? This is my commercial.
And nice Face, hello.
What is this?
And I'm gonna write it at the bottom of the screen.
Uh-huh.
And
please go to what I said.
I am here.
Cause this.
Stand. I don't recognize this one. Turn down for what?
I don't know how, but please subscribe.
And we just
whatever.com.
That's Switzerland.
Oh, just come outside. I send that. Yeah, yeah. Fee.
Don't know what to say.
I already did right it. Please, let me alone. You. Leave me alone,
go
please.
To what I say. Good night, boys. I'm gay. I like
boys. What is this? What is this? What if we... Air dot.
I can't even type. Who does exist? No.
I am like a native speaker, you know, America, Great Britain.
Oh, why are you disrespecting me, bro?
Another thing I wanna say is that I'm, as you know, I have Russian accent, so I live in East Europe, and we guys in East Europe, we are fucking tired. We don't pay money for games. We don't buy games. Moreover, we hate ads. Any ad for us is an insult. So every one of us use adblock. We don't like ads. This app, this shitty app made by FaceDev is full of ads. Its meaning is only to do ads. I hate it!
Please move the ads in front of her. Like, I don't want to see this screen. This is why this extension was made. The people watching need to realize this is editing.
Firstly, you should be subscribed on... Fuck! Boosin Industries! I don't understand anything.
Does that ever happen to you?
I like
that
it.
The words don't come out?
Bombocler. Oh.
Talk about.
Okay,
each
nice.
Topic has suggestions to take your speaking to the next nice. Level. It's You're like right. having an English.
Boosin Industries.
This is my commercial spot.
It works.
Ma'am, do not ring the card. Ma'am, no, I don't hear no. Do not ring the card.
Okay.
Let's see what this game is.
Nice. I did this. I had a virus.
No escape, baby!
I don't understand what is he speaking. Python, listen.
Boston Industries.
We are not in Boston. Shut up. It's not Boston.
Anyways, I give this a 1 out of 10. It's not worth not install. Do not even read the code to this. Worker 621. Oh.
Anyway, yeah, that was Boston Darker Room. If you want to try...
Right, so I interrupt this outro to promote the secondary channel where lower quality FaceDev projects, that's me, okay, will be posted. And I also got GNOME, right? So, and we're gonna fill that thing there and we'll just kind of do projects, I guess. So, check that out. Make sure not miss it. And back to the video.
Yeah, so GitHub link in the description if you want to try the extension out. The instructions are also in there. Thanks to Incogni for sponsoring this video. Don't forget to click the link in the description to get a cool discount. Thanks for watching. As always,
I am always watching.
Bonus gambling fuck. Segment.
Do I go all in again? Chat, do I go all in?
Featuring yes, a live okay. audience.
Okay, fuck. Do I stand or hit? Yeah.
Did I? No! No! Why?
It doesn't give me 21 instantly. It used to give me 21 instantly. Why? You choose to hit. Well, experts... If you're not giving me an option to go back, why are you telling me that?
Where's the fucking logic?
Again. Fuck. Oh, this game is so easy.
All in again.
Fuck. Do I rely on... Okay, stand.
Fuck.
Da-na-na-na. No, sneak deserves that shit I'm doing like no.